What has your publicity experience taught you about making swift yet effective decisions?
You know, sometimes you have to make a decision, you just have to make it. Yeah. It's the end of the story. You know, in some of the circumstances that I've had to deal with in the public sector, you don't have a whole lot of time. So again, you try to be as prepared as you can. You have a media list on you at all times. I've got it saved on my phone so you can make calls to press contacts. Obviously, you can also use that to email folks if you want to put together a press release. There have been plenty of times where something happens and you want to capture some of that publicity. And again, it's like body surfing. You just have to capture that wave just right. You know, you have to get on top of that wave that's already moving.
Yeah.
And you have to get on at the right speed and know, you know, how heavy your body is and, you know, and how you're going to be able to ride this wave all the way in or not. Is the wave big enough to carry you in? What I'll do is I remember that there's not just one or two types of outlets in the news. It's not just, you know, some of the mainstream print media and, of course, the mainstream TV news. But I also remember about the widely used popular blogs in Austin, some of the off-brand magazines and radio shows. So depending on what the publicity story is, I may wind up getting a lot of good write-up in a blog or in one of our alternative magazines or be, you know, on a radio show, but you get very little on the newspaper or on the mainstream television stations. It's just knowing how to ride that wave.